Not just something that they made up. The WBO really does have something called a super champion, even though it doesn't really mean that you're a champion. And the WBO is one of the more stricter organizations between the WBC, IBF, and the, you know, WBA. Now, when it comes to the WBO and the IBF, they will strip your ass if you do not fight your mandatory or if you do not defend your title within a year. Now, I'm going to post a couple of links down in the description box so you can see, basically, like, read for yourself what the WBO Super Champion means. So, if you don't know, Timothy Bradley defeated... Timothy Bradley defeated Jesse Vargas for the WBO interim title. But what happened was he became the WBO full champion at 147 pounds because Floyd Mayweather, who beaten Pacquiao for that WBO title, didn't pay his sanctioning fees. Floyd Mayweather wanted to stay as far as away from the WBO title as possible because the WBO is somewhat in bed with Bob Arum and is somewhat like somewhat of you could say a HBO belt. So what would have happened was if Floyd Mayweather would have kept that WBO title, he would have been ordered to fight Timothy Bradley, and hence we would have had another promotional thing where Bob Arum and Timothy Bradley would have had. I mean, Bob Arum and Al Haymon would have had to work together again. And Timothy Bradley is just not a big enough fighter to make that happen. No offense to Timothy Bradley. So what happened was Timothy Bradley decided to fight Manny Pacquiao. Manny Pacquiao decided to fight Timothy Bradley. The WBO had already stated that Saddam Ali was the Golden Boy fighter. Saddam Ali was the WBO number one contender. And basically now you have Saddam Ali fighting Jesse Vargas for the WBO title. Now, Timothy Bradley hasn't been stripped. Timothy Bradley and Manny Pacquiao will be fighting for the WBO super champion status. I don't know if they're going to have a belt. I don't know whatever the case is. You know what? I don't know if there's going to actually be a belt on the line, or is it going to be just that super champion status? What that means is, after Jesse Vargas and Saddam Ali, the winner of that would have to fight the winner of Pacquiao versus Bradley. So basically making them the automatic number one contender again. So Timothy Bradley, if you don't know, or if you do already know, is taking on Manny Pacquiao April the 9th, 2016. It's supposed to be Manny Pacquiao's last fight. However, Manny Pacquiao is saying that he will fight again if the Mayweather fight comes up. And me personally, I really don't believe that he's retired. And I believe that he should continue to fight. You know, I believe that fighting, in my opinion, and I don't want to get too deep in it, he can do more good fighting than he would in politics. But there's not too many fights out there for him, especially since he can't really fight Al Haymon guys, you know, like a Keith Thurman, a Sean Porter, you know, a Adrian Broner, who was rumored, but I pretty much knew that fight wasn't going to happen, you know, a Danny Garcia, guys like that. I mean, can you imagine what a Pacquiao versus Madonna would do if Madonna came out of it, like if Madonna came out of retirement? That would be crazy. But, you know, the WBA has a WBA Super World Champion and a WBA World Champion. And what I've learned is that unless the WBA decides to do it themselves, they will fuck with you. You know, like if your name is not Floyd Mayweather, you know, like they will, or Andre Ward, they didn't do it to him. They will sometime make the WBA World Champion fight the WBA Super World Champion. But according to Keith Thurman, he said that he couldn't go to the WBA and say, I want to fight Floyd Mayweather, you know, because he's saying that when you're the WBA champion, Super World champion, you have no mandatories, which is one of the reasons why maybe we won't see Danny Jacobs, who's the WBA World Champion, versus Gennady Golovkin, which is the WBA Super World Champion, which would be a perfect fight at this point in time in career, in both of their careers, you know. But I believe that when it comes to the WBA, they don't want to unify their titles. They want to keep it the WBA World and the WBA Super World. They want to have two belts. But when it comes to this whole WBO situation, when it comes to making Timothy Bradley the super champion, it's just clear to me that they, for one, they don't want to strip Timothy Bradley. And two, they want to make sure to get those sanctioning fees for Pacquiao versus Bradley 3, which could be Pacquiao's biggest fight. And also, it's going to be the biggest payday the WBO had because Floyd Mayweather basically won the belt and burnt them for their money. So that's pretty much the definition of that. When will Saddam Ali versus Jesse Vargas happen? I don't know. No date's official yet. I know it's a date. Let me type it in real quick. Let me see. I don't think they came up with a date yet, but Vargas versus Ali. But I'm thinking sometime in March or April. I don't know if it's going to be on the... They should put it on the undercard of Pacquiao versus Bradley 3. Wouldn't that make sense? But I'm T-Street Controversy. This is T-Street Controversy Live. I cover every single major fight live. Please subscribe.